Philippine authorities refute allegations of controversial religious leader Apollo Quiboloy, who claimed there were threats to his life. Quiboloy also dared to face congressional hearings into his alleged abuses or risk getting arrested. Sherian Torres reports.
The Philippine National Police says there is no information on alleged threats to televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. The leader of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ on Wednesday claimed the Marcos administration and U.S. authorities are out to get him, allegedly through rendition or assassination. Quiboloy admitted he is in hiding because of threats to his life. He has also been skipping congressional hearings seeking his testimony on various allegations involving his church and the SMNI network. The PNP says it is ready to assist the Office of the Senate Sergeant-at-Arms to serve the subpoena on Quiboloy if asked. The Federal Bureau of Investigation, for its part, denies Quiboloy's claim that a $2 million bounty is being offered for his arrest. The FBI also shared its wanted poster featuring Quiboloy, who is accused of sex trafficking, fraud and coercion, conspiracy, and bulk cash smuggling. Senator Risa Ontiveros, who leads the committee hearing, says the allegations against Quiboloy rules out a virtual appearance for the embattled pastor.
Magpakita muna siya ng kahandaang i-honor yung subpoena at humarap, no, mag-appear sa harap ng komite. Pag hindi siya nag-appear sa March 5, aresto na ang susunod dahil iko-contempt ko siya.
House lawmakers also urged Quiboloy to face the music. They laughed off Quiboloy's assertions many of his women followers are fighting over him because he is single and rich. Witnesses who claim to be former KOJC church members recounted during two Senate hearings how they were allegedly raped by the self-styled Son of God.
Kay Quiboloy, huwag kang feelingero. Akala mo ay hinahabol ka ng mga kababaihan. Hinahabol ka dahil sa accountability mo at pananagutan mo sa mga kababaihan. Humarap ka talaga doon sa mga pagdinig sa Senado at sa House of Representatives.
The next Senate hearing is set on March 5 and it will focus on accusations of human trafficking and the abuse of children and women by Quiboloy. On March 12, the House Committee on Legislative Franchises resumes its probe into the reported franchise violations of the Suarasug Media Corporation. Suarasug operates Sunshine Media Network Incorporated, or SMNI, believed to be owned by Quiboloy. Meantime, an expert in Asian church and culture says Quiboloy's case does not fall on the Constitution's separation of church and state clause.
Sapagkat siya ay citizen ng Pilipinas, and he has publicly and unlawfully been out of line, ano, dun sa mga charges ng sexual abuse, money laundering, at saka kung ano-ano. Hindi siya religious crime. It's a public crime.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Justice Department issues two alert list orders against expelled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. The orders direct all immigration officers to promptly report any information on his entry or exit in the country to authorities. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the orders were issued to restrict Teves' movement and facilitate his arrest. The Anti-Terrorism Council designated Teves a terrorist, citing several killings in Negros Oriental. Teves is the suspected mastermind in the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo and several others in March last year. A Philippine opposition senator casting doubts the upper chamber can pass the resolution pushing for economic amendments in the Constitution. At least 18 votes are needed for the Senate to pass its charter change resolution, but Senator Risa Ontiveros sees at least 7 senators voting against the proposal.
Sa Senado, nakapagdaos na po ng 3 pagdinig. Isa po doon ay sa rehiyon at ipagpapatuloy dahil na talakay pa lamang yung general principles, tapos yung gusto nilang amiendahan di umano sa ating public utilities pa at sa edukasyon. Pagpapatuloy pa yon, and then tatalakayin pa daw yung sa advertising. Pero tingin ko yung una nilang sinabing meron na silang 18 votes para aprubahan yan sa Senado, duda ko na accurate yon. At mas accurate sabihin na may fighting chance tayong makabuo ng pito namin kasama si Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel na boboto ng no sa RBH6.
Meanwhile, a House leader rejects calls for the lower chamber to adopt the Senate's charter change resolution, which pushes for separate voting of Congress.
Siguro ang marapat na tanungin natin ang Senado bakit nila nilagay yun. Kasi sa where the House stands is we have to follow the Constitution. And the Constitution simply says that members Congress by 3/4 vote of all its members. So kinopya lang ho natin yun doon. Bakit nila dinagdag yung voting separately? Kasi kung babasahin mo naman yung Constitution, wala namang sinabing voting jointly, wala naman ding sinabing voting separately.
The Philippine opposition bears some of its Senate bets for the country's 2025 midterm polls. Liberal Party spokesperson Laila De Lima says they will field former Senators Kiko Pangilinan and Bam Aquino as opposition candidates. The party will also field human rights lawyer Shel Diokno. De Lima's camp adds they are trying to convince former Vice President Lenny Robredo to join and lead the opposition slate. Robredo ran for president in 2022 elections with Pangilinan as her running mate. The joint venture led by South Korean firm Miro Systems bags the vote counting machine contract for next year's Philippine midterm elections, replacing controversial poll technology provider Smartmatic. More from Victoria Tulad.
After more than a month of post-qualification evaluation, the Commission on Elections has declared the joint venture of South Korean firm Miro Systems Company Limited as the winning bidder of the 18.8 billion peso fast-track project for the May 2025 automated elections. Under the fast-track, or full automation system with transparency audit count, the joint venture will supply the hardware, which includes 110,000 automated counting machines, laptops, ballot boxes and ballots, the software or the consolidation and canvassing system, and the election management system. The three Filipino companies that make up the joint venture are Integrated Computer Systems Incorporated, St. Timothy Construction Corporation, and Centerpoint Solutions Technologies Incorporated. They are the lone bidder for the said project.
Nag-desisyon ng Commission and Bank, unanimous po kami. Inadapt namin yung recommendation ng aming Special Bids and Awards Committee at yung mga findings ng TWG, amin din pong inadapt at sinasabi na dapat maibigay ang award sa Miro System at ang kanyang joint venture.
With the joint venture's bid amounting to 17.9 billion pesos, COMELEC will be able to save about 800 million pesos. A huge factor in favoring Miro was its compliance with the wish list of COMELEC, such as faster feeding of ballots to the machine from 7 to 9 seconds to 2 to 3 seconds. The machine will also have a 13-inch screen for voters to countercheck if it records the right names and an attached receptacle for the election receipts. During the demonstration of Miro on February 21, the poll chief said it was able to show its capability in transmitting election results to various stakeholders.
Nagulat kami talaga sapagkat hindi namin ine-expect na yung lahat ng ni-require namin o ni-request namin sa amin pong wish list sa terms of reference na nilabas namin nung nakaraang taon pa ay eksakto po nakuha nitong Miro.
Garcia clarified that they will only be leasing or renting the automated counting machines.
Napakahirap po kapag binili natin ang makina sapagkat ang isa pong equipment na katulad niyan, yung modern technology, ay lagi nagbabago po yung teknolohiya natin every 3 months, every 6 months. Pag po binili natin, number one, i-warehouse po natin yan. Napakamahal po ng warehousing.
The poll chief assured that the COMELEC investigated allegations of problematic elections conducted by Miro in Iraq and the Democratic Republic of Congo and received certification from these countries.
Nagsasabi yung mga pinuno po ng election management bodies na ito na naging maayos yung kanilang halalang contrary po doon sa mga nai-report. So kung mismong ang pinuno, katulad ko po, ay nagsasabing maayos yung halala namin, walang naging problema, at hanggang ngayon naman wala tayong nakikita naging problema doon sa bansang yon. So parang medyo mali po siguro yung kumalat na balita.
Asked if the May 2025 elections will be smoother with a new elections technology provider, Garcia said it will still depend on other elements such as vote buying and the presence of armed groups that threaten voters and teachers. Garcia pointed out that after the notice of award, COMELEC and the joint venture will still have to undergo a contract negotiation before signing a notice to proceed. Miru will then produce the automated counting machines within 6 months, which will have to undergo tests and international certification. There will also be a local review of the source code. In a statement, Miru thanked COMELEC. The company said it was able to show the efficiency and sophistication of its machines in a transparent and fair bidding. Miru also committed to proving the quality of its machines and looks forward to elevating the Philippines' democratic processes. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
A new report shows China's activities have caused massive damage to the marine environment in the South China Sea. Researchers from the Center for Strategic and International Studies say Chinese activities have destroyed at least 21,000 acres of coral reefs. This is mainly due to clam harvesting and dredging in landfills to build artificial islands. The report mentioned the damage documented by the Armed Forces of the Philippines in September 2023, which showed crushed corals on the seabed of Iroquois Reef and Sabina Shoal. China has constantly denied allegations of polluting and damaging the marine environment. It even accused the Philippines of causing damage by not removing the BRP Sierra Madre, its lone Navy outpost in Ayungin Shoal. The Philippine Coast Guard denies its Chinese counterpart's claims it repelled a vessel of the Fisheries Bureau for supposedly intruding into Scarborough Shoal. In a statement on social media platform X, PCG spokesperson Commodore Jay Tariella called Beijing's claims inaccurate. He insists the BRP Datu Sandai continues its patrols off Scarborough Shoal. Tariella was responding to a post on X by Chinese state-run Global Times, which claimed the Chinese Coast Guard repelled the Fisheries Bureau ship for intruding into Chinese waters. An international court ruled in 2016 that the Philippines has fishing rights over the Scarborough Shoal in the West Philippine Sea. But Beijing continues to ignore Manila's arbitral victory. President Marcos speaks to Indonesia's presidential election frontrunner on strengthening bilateral ties. Marcos held a phone call Thursday with Prabowo Subianto to congratulate him on his presumptive victory. The president told Prabowo he hopes to build on the relationship established by ongoing Indonesian President Joko Widodo. Marcos said his administration is looking forward to collaborating with Jakarta in energy production and energy transition. The unofficial count in the Indonesian polls shows Prabowo clinching the presidency with a comfortable 58% majority vote. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Aldar Aurelio. Hi, Aldar.
Hello, Bettina, and also to all of to our televiewers. Right now, the northeast monsoon is starting to affect over extreme northern Luzon, but easterlies is still continue to affect the whole country, almost the whole country. So we expect, based on easterlies, northern Mindanao, Davao region, and Caraga will have a cloudy sky with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms, while the rest of the country will have generally good and warmer weather condition, but expect isolated rain showers due to thunderstorm. Today and tomorrow and Sunday, almost whole country will have generally fair weather, but expect isolated rain showers and thunderstorm. Northeast monsoon expect to strengthen and tomorrow and by Sunday, northeast monsoon expect to affect almost the northern and central Luzon. Today we had there's no real warning, so expect moderate to rough seas over extreme northern zone, and while the rest of the country expect a slight to moderate seas. That's our weather update from Pagasa. I am Alzar D. Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Alzar.